Students, in our last lecture of integrated marketing communication, we had discussed about direct marketing, public relations and sales promotion. In this lecture, we will discuss about some more concepts in marketing communication. First concept is product placement. So it is simply a way of communication or promotion, but not through an advertisement, but placing a product in a program or in a movie. So while we see a movie or while we see a program, then we see some characters in movies or those programs using a product or a brand. So that brand is not being promoted directly but indirectly, because we see the characters in movies or programs using those products or brands. Or those products or brands are simply flashed during the movie or the program is going on. So this concept is called product placement. As it is said, it is mentioned, some characters in movies or TV shows are shown using or promoting a product or a brand. So any character in movie or TV show are shown using or promoting a product or a brand. So it is not an advertisement, it is a TV program or it is a movie, and in that movie or a program a product or brand is being promoted or being flashed or being used by a character. Sometimes the brand names are flashed in the movies or TV shows. Movie or show makers are paid in cash or kind. So for this promotion, the marketers pay those movie or show makers in terms of money or in terms of any other kind. It could be a money or it could be like something else. Maybe a marketer may provide a place, its property for shooting. Maybe a marketer, if it's a soft drink company, then that soft drink company may say that okay, for the whole movie shooting, the soft drinks will be provided by that marketer. Or if it is a company that offers sweets or food items, then that company may say that okay, for the whole shooting we'll provide the food and sweet items. So that type of kind may be also paid. You might have seen the movie Prem Ratan Dhan Payo. In that movie, the characters are shown using a brand, sweet brand, perhaps Haldiram. So that is simply an example of product placement. Another concept is advertorial. So these are the indirect forms of communication, that product placement, advertorial, and the others that we'll discuss in next slides. So these are indirect forms of communication and promotion in which the marketer is not promoting the product or brand directly. It is indirectly being promoted. In advertorials, these are the print ads that offer advertorial. Advertorial word comes from advertisement and editorial. It is a combination of two words. Advertisement and editorials. So editorials are something that are written in newspapers or magazines, in which editors write something, and advertisements are there in newspapers that we see. So a combination of both, editorial. These are print ads that offer editorial content. So these are actually ads which are paid ads. The marketer pays to the newspaper or magazine for these ads, but these look like newspaper content. So it looks like newspaper content, but it actually promotes a brand, and it is, the newspaper is paid for this content. So it is mentioned, these are print ads that offer editorial content that reflects favorably on the brand and is difficult to distinguish from newspaper magazine content. So the question is, why these advertorials are used? Actually, these advertorials format is just the same as newspaper content, news of the newspaper, the similar format is used. Though the newspaper is being paid for this, so as the content, it is difficult for the reader to distinguish between newspaper content and this editorial content. So reader may perceive that this is the content of newspaper, this is a news published by the newspaper. So as news are more reliable, readers perceive that whatever is there in news, that is more reliable, and whatever is published as advertisement, that might not be that much reliable. So readers may find it difficult to distinguish between this ad content from the newspaper content, and reader may perceive that this is newspaper content, this is news about this product, and that is why that is more reliable. So that is the advantage of editorials, that users or readers may rely much on that because it is in the same format as the news. But the disadvantage is that as it has the content is the same as the format of a news, so it is it has more heavy text, less pictures, less bold headings, it is less attractive. So it gets attention of a reader, that is somewhat difficult that it gets attention from readers. So though it is more reliable, but it is difficult to get reader's attention. That is why it is not used very commonly, it is used rarely and very carefully used. Next topic that we would discuss is buzz and viral marketing. Again, these are indirect forms of communication and promotion. First, we'll discuss buzz marketing. Buzz marketing generates excitement, creates publicity, and conveys brand related information through non-conventional means. So there are some non-conventional means of promotion or communication, and because of that non-conventional means or something that is different, that attracts audience attention. And because of that attention, audience keep on talking about that, try to know more about that, and that creates buzz. So just a simple example, if you see a different type of ad in TV, a different type of ad in newspaper, or maybe simply a a balloon, a hot air balloon in air, which you don't see very commonly, very frequently in your area, then you would try to find out why this hot air balloon is there. So then you see that there is a brand name mentioned on that hot air balloon. So that is again attracting the attention of users. Another very good and classic example of this buzz marketing, I could recall two examples. One example, when the RSPL company was about to launch its milk brand Namaste India in Kanpur. So the company had hoardings all over the city mentioning ye gaada maza kya hai, ye gaada maza kya hai, ye gaada maza kya hai. So everyone was curious about knowing that gaada maza kya hai, what is this gaada maza. So then that buzz was there in the market that something is going to happen that talks about gaada maza, and that all the audience were curious to know more about gaada maza. Then gradually the company launched the milk brand Namaste India and mentioned that it is gaada maza. Similarly, Hindustan newspaper, when it was about to launch its Hindi newspaper in Kanpur, it had hoardings all over the city, har khabar ki kise khabar, har khabar ki kise khabar. So everyone was again curious, and there was a buzz in the market that what is this har khabar ki kise khabar, and what is this related to, what is this all about, who's having these holdings and why these holdings are there. So people were curious up to know about this har khabar ki kise khabar. Then it launched its newspaper in Kanpur with caption har khabar ki hame khabar Hindustan. So this buzz marketing helps to create buzz, and then creates interest, and jo target audience want to know more about that brand, about product. So this is all about buzz marketing. While viral marketing encourages customers to pass along company developed communication material like audio, video and other information online. So in viral marketing, a company creates some promotion material or communication material, but that promotion or communication material is very interesting, and that being interesting is shared by, it could be an audio video or anything else, it could be audio video, image, a picture, anything else. So it being interesting is shared by individuals themselves online, over social media, over mobile phones, over internet. So the marketer just needs to invest in creating this communication, but marketer does not have to invest much in communicating or promoting or in spreading this. It spreads itself. Why it gets spread? Because it is interesting, so everyone shares it with others. So with this interesting audio or video or picture, the marketer's message or brand name is also shared, and that helps in enhancing the brand image or the message of the marketer. Sprite has done very well with this. I could recall one example. Yes, I could recall one example for Sprite. There was a joke over the internet and social media that once a husband comes back to his home, and he always has alcohol, and when he comes back to his home, he always talks with his wife in a good way, tell her that she is very beautiful, she is very good looking. And so once he comes back home and says that she is not looking good, she looks like a very dangerous lady. So she said that every day you come back to your home, our home, and you praise me. Today you are not praising me, instead you are insulting me. So he said, every day I have alcohol, but today I had Sprite. So no bakwas, it's clear. So I'm just talking what is clear, and I'm having no bakwas, so everything is clear to me. So this was an interesting joke, and being interesting, it was shared by users over social media. And with this joke, Sprite's name and its message was also shared. So why it is called viral marketing? Because without any efforts, just like a virus, it gets spread. So marketer does not have to make any efforts to spread it. It is spread automatically because it is interesting. That is why it is called viral. Viral and buzz marketing are driven by the rules of entertainment. As I have said, that it should be interesting, it should be entertaining, and that's why those are shared, those are forwarded by the users over the internet. These are addictive and self-propagating advertisement. Those live on the website, blogs, cell phones and message boards. So as these are self-propagating, addictive, that's why these live on websites, blogs, cell phones and message boards. And this is more specific, that whatever is over internet and website, blogs, those, only those things can be included in viral marketing. So that's all for this lecture. I'll get back for some new topics in my next lectures. Thank you.